I'm tanned, I'm rested, and I'm ready to give this old town a wedgie again.
Oh God, Sega.
You've seen it? We haven't done Sonic in years.
You've seen us do Namco RPG, so I thought we'd do a change of pace and do a Sega RPG instead.
And not just an RPG, a MMORPG.
Damn.
Shit. So then this means to complete the trifecta, one of us has to record a Final Fantasy.
I'm on it. I'll record 14 within the next week.
No,
hell no. I really won't. Fuck that.
If you're gonna record any Square Enix RPG, record Chrono Trigger for us.
But you've already recorded that.
I know. I did that as a solo run. Well, I did it with you, but Luigi didn't. And that's the fastest. And that's the fastest Square Enix RPG I can think of.
For the record, this game has 6 intros.
Beautiful.
Are you gonna show off all 6 of them?
When they come out.
Okay.
We don't have them all yet.
I figured
since episode 4 is just literally around the corner, we may as well just get a jump start on where episode 2 is right now.
I really want to play this game, but I also am just waiting for the Switch version.
And for those wondering, Fangstore Online, this game has nothing to do with the first game, so it's like, yeah, you're not missing a goddamn thing.
At least it doesn't retcon the first game, or does it?
It doesn't. No, this is its own universe, so it doesn't really retcon anything.
Okay.
Nah.
It can't retcon what doesn't exist.
Well,
it's like the Xenoblade Chronicles universe and the Xenoblade Chronicles X universe, just separate things. They don't really interact with one another at all. Yeah.
That's why it has absolutely nothing.
Ah, the one place free from war.
Space! And it has absolutely nothing to do with the original Phantasy Star on Genesis either. The 3 games that nobody remembers.
Well, it does reference them at least.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, there's like 4
Phantasy Star Online 2! Phantasy Star Online. This is the series I grew up. This is the RPG series I grew up with.
And the sequel just came out.
Yes. Shut up.
I remember it came out on GameCube. I never the first one, episode 1 and 2, was on GameCube. I never got around to it though.
Yeah. If you want me to play those games, no. Those games are hard as shit. The episode 1 of that game is hard as shit. I ain't doing it.
Yeesh. I remember being interested in buying Phantasy Star episode 1 and 2 on GameCube so long ago, but I was all like, I don't know if I want to commit to that. But I was young and dumb back then.
I don't know how the online aspect of it worked, considering it's for America was the only GameCube game to have online.
It was online in Japan. We didn't get that.
Oh, we didn't get the online
because
well,
GameCube did have like an adapter for like a LAN cable, but it either never really released or had a really limited release here in the U.S. So
it didn't release online.
Was impossible.
Is there a reason it did not release
for so long?
What's that?
Is there a reason the title screen's been up for so long?
Because it takes a while for the next intro to load.
Oh, okay.
No, I'm not showing all the intros in this part, don't worry.
Calm down. No, I never said that. I was more worried that when you were recording that maybe this froze or something.
No, it's normal. If you see it moving, it's normal.
Yeah, true.
Well, I just remember when you started playing this, like, when it came out on Xbox One first, before PC. Then, like, a couple weeks later, he's like, okay, I understand why Logic plays 14 so much. I'm like,
that's the only thing keeping me from playing MMOs, is I don't want to dedicate my entire life to playing a game that never stops.
I mean,
well, technically this game does have an ending, we just don't have it yet.
Yeah.
I say that, and I play, like, 4 mobile games on my phone, so what are you going to do?
But yeah.
MMOs, you get hard into them early on, but then once you've done most of what you find entertaining, you kind of like take a back, kind of takes a back seat.
That's kind of why I'm concerned about buying this. I don't want to buy a $60 game to play it for a month and then be done with it and never touch it again.
Good news.
This game is free to play.
It is. You don't have to buy it. The only thing, technically, if you're waiting for the Switch version, the only thing you're paying for is the online Switch service, which is a completely separate entity.
Yeah, I just have to download it once it comes out on the eShop.
Yeah, the game is free to play, free to download. You don't have to pay a goddamn thing unless you really want extra inventory space or ease of access to certain parts of the server.
Anyways, I should really explain what I should actually explain what's going on screen.
Sorry.
We spent the entire intro talking about how it's free to play.
I mean, that's its main draw.
We were only talking for 20 seconds. It's not our fault that the intro is only 20 seconds long.
Are you sure about that?
Anyways, There are four races in total in this game that you can play as. Does it matter which one you play? No, it does not. It doesn't mean a goddamn thing.
Oh, good. Yeah. So it's like Dot Hack, where they give you the twin blades, and it doesn't matter because that's the only class you can use anyway. Nice to meet you,
mate. There are multiple classes you can use in this game. I'm showcasing the default hunter look.
Yeah. You I'm talking to.
This is Nathan. He's our partner for. He's gonna be our partner for this entire game. So let's make
the most of it. Yeah. Why don't you just use your overpowered OC that you've been using?
Why? I can't use them during story quests anyway.
Yeah. So this is pretty much just the opening to show you how to play the game in general, and then.
Yeah. I would use them, but I can't right now because they won't let me play the tutorial with them. I don't know why.
Because from what I understand, the tutorial is pretty much instant to each individual player, so it's like you won't be able to play with other people until you clear the tutorial.
It's one of those games.
That's true. I didn't think about that. By the way, don't get used to voiceovers during gameplay. You're never gonna see that.
Yeah, most you'll ever hear is like little grunts here and there. Thanks. Or the occasional emergency.
God damn it, Sega. Spend a little more budget on this game, why don't you? You already
there
made
we
it
go.
You at least made it look gorgeous. Go the extra mile for full voice acting, even if
by the way, don't get used to that intro either, because you're never gonna see it again.
God damn it, Sega, why are you so lazy?
Listen, it's free to play. It's not like they have to put much effort into
calm down. This game is 8 years old already.
No, yeah.
I know. That's the other thing I'm thinking of. Like, by the time we got this, like, I won't be surprised if next year Japan gets Phantasy Star Online 3.
It's not. They already said it's not, because this game's not done yet.
Not even.
No, we still well, how still, long has, was, still has
well,
another
how long
few
was episode? Well, how long was Phantasy Star Online 1?
Three episodes long, and each episode with its own game. I will begin
your certification mission.
Oh, so it is the Dot Hack approach, where they cut the game into three long games.
Yep.
Nice.
Except for this game, which puts all of its episodes into the same game.
You didn't seem to have any
trouble. So you just have to wait until they update every couple months.
Did you try to attack the map?
I can't actually hit him. I know what I'm doing. Shut up.
Okay, tutorial bitch, let's just go through the wall.
You want to double jump? Get to level 40 first.
Why? Use your equipped weapon to attack. Why does all the good stuff have to be halfway into the game?
Halfway my ass.
Right. I was about to say, I'm like, no, you don't get to level 40 that quick either.
No, that's my
point. No, you don't.
Isn't the max level for this game right now only like 70?
75 80. Or 80.
80.
It goes up every five. It goes up every five levels after like, a major update. It goes up every five levels after a major update.
As of this recording, it's level 80? Okay, fair enough.
Yeah, as of this recording, episode 4 has not released yet. It will later in August.
As long as there's still content for people to do, they'll keep playing it.
Also, this game, when I said this game is not done yet, I meant it, because this game is supposed to last Sega 10 years, and it's only been 8.
See, that's the other thing, though. Like, by the time this game comes out on the Switch, you know what else is going to be out on the Switch? Final Fantasy Crystal Chronicles. God damn it.
You act like we're going to be playing that game forever.
Right, that's not MMO material.
I know, but Crystal Chronicles, it's like a pseudo-MMO at least.
Not really. I mean, it'll have multiplayer, but it's not necessarily something like that.
From what I remember of it, it has been like 5 or 6 years since I've played it, but it's like kind of an MMO, not quite. Now don't forget that feeling. It has MMO-like qualities to it, to commence your practical
training. I should mention, when you do perfect, you can do perfect attacks when you see that circle around your character, when it turns red, and you attack when it turns red, that's considered a perfect attack. You do more damage that way. It's very, very, very easy to do, and also very, very hard to notice when you're a gunner.
So since both of you have this, are there any major differences between the console version and the PC version?
Nope.
Not really, no.
Okay.
I mean, with the PC version, the only thing that's the difference is just how your PC is built. Other than that...
Like, I assume the PC version runs in a native 60 FPS or some crap?
Depends on your PC, obviously.
Yeah, it depends on the PC.
Fair enough.
Like, with the Xbox One, it's obviously more consistent across every Xbox One, just because, you know, they all have... relatively speaking, the same specs, but a PC can vary wildly from person to person.
Right.
Oh, I should actually bring this up, because there's a reason I named the character Ash.
Oh no.
Is he about to catch them all?
No, it's not that Ash. Shit. Shut up. No. And this game actually had two promo animes released for it. One of them was called Episode Oracle. The main character of that one was named Ash, and he looked exactly like the Hunter character, the default Hunter character. And that's what they're going with this, because technically the main character of this story is technically named Ash.
I was gonna say, is it a Tales of the Abyss reference? Because then you got someone else that's like Luke, but eh.
No,
not to mention, it would be kind of misspelled at this point, too, because he forgot the E, if that were the case.
Yeah. That's how his name is spelled, I can't help that.
Yeah. I'm just saying, this, Phantasy Star Ash,
I mean,
and
you don't have to have it spelled the same way to have it still be a semi-reference.
Also, I just want to bring up the fact that Hilda calls us damage. Which means she can technically kill us if she really wanted to. She's has, like, the hand of God for some reason.
Fuck it.
Oh, is this going to be one of those games where you're actually working for the villains the whole time and they just
Stop doing that.
Be prepared to hear that a lot.
Stop trying to predict the story. It's not going to happen. Also, Aethon got bitch smacked and so did I.
Yep.
That didn't do that much damage. That did, though.
You were saying?
Yeah, most attacks are pretty telegraphed, so you just gotta really keep an eye on, like, the enemy's movements. For the most part.
I'm so used to being so high up that I never had this happen.
No, yeah, if you power level enough, like, you can just tank everything.
Yeah. Also, like, from all your streams that I've watched, you also usually are...
He tried the people's elbow! He just tried the people's elbow!
I'm so used to watching your streams where you're up on a cliff just sniping at things, not actually getting up in their face.
Yeah, well, that changed.
Shit.
You don't really have much of a choice right now.
Well, I'm the hunter. I kind of don't.
No, that's... Well, could you choose to be a sniper?
Yes. Yes, you can choose whichever class you want. It's just I just chose this as a reference to the anime.
Is the anime actually good? Because I've never actually seen it.
Oracle is good. The other one, not so much.
Maybe I'll look into Oracle later then.
Oracle sums up the entirety of episode one of this game, actually. Also, it's a lot more graphic in this game.
Yeah, I kind of I do remember you mentioning that.
Like, you know how in this game the enemies just fall down, they disappear? In the anime, they get ripped to fucking shreds, dude.
Oh, yay, ads in the load screen.
You see blood splatter everywhere. It's like, fuck.
Logic, what class did you pick when you started this game?
Fuck, what was the name of it? The one with, like, the bow and the katana?
That's
like,
the Braver class.
Braver, yeah, Braver.
Bravers use katanas and bows. If you're smart, you would stick with the katana. What's
happening? I am not a smart man.
You tried Robin Hood, didn't you?
Oh, hell yeah!
You dumbass!
Well, you juggle between this and Final Fantasy XIV, so...
To be fair, I haven't really played this in about a month, but at the same
because
time,
you play this for 5 minutes, and then you go, oh shit, I gotta go play Final Fantasy XIV, otherwise people think I'm dead.
Not to mention, I do have more of a community in 14. I mean...
Yeah.
I don't blame him for it.
These are the main type of enemies you're going to be fighting in story mode. These are known as Falspawn.
Yep.
Why are they a threat? Because these are strong enough to take to rule the entire universe. Why? I don't know.
Of course.
Dark Falls is a giant
evil
something. A giant something. I don't know if they retconned what he was from the original Phantasy Star.
Yes. Yes, they do.
Okay, because in the original Phantasy Stars, he's just kind of an alien that possesses a supercomputer. He's basically Alien Sigma, at least in the Sega versions.
Who's this red-looking clone motherfucker?
Oh, it's this jackass.
Like, who are you? I'm you, but red.
Speaking of Sigma and Mega Man X, here's Zero with a gun.
You know what's funny, Logic? You're not wrong.
I'm not. I can tell immediately.
Oh, man.
He's a pretty chill dude, though.
Yeah, the Zeno's pretty chill.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, oh,
this
man.
This is Zeno. His main weapon is a gun blade. You're
certainly calm for I think Gunblade's another video. Thing that Bravers can use, too.
Yeah, Gunblades all classes can use.
Oh, okay.
Wait, so is it like Squall's Gunblade?
No, it's actually practical. You can actually switch. You can actually switch modes.
Yeah.
You can switch between it being a gun and switch to it being a weapon.
Out of curiosity, not to rag on the voice acting too much, but do you have the option of choosing the Japanese language or not?
Yes.
Yes, I believe you do, but I can't remember. By the way, don't get used to this either.
Right? The day I was waiting for.
Mm-hmm. Oh, hey, chat box. Let's just pretend that doesn't exist.
Not like it's gonna say anything. Not like it's gonna show anything.
Yeah. Yeah, otherwise this video would get flagged. You should try
various kinds of weapons until you. It's just more like a history of showing, like, what's been said in, like, by NPCs and whatnot, just so you can kind of remember.
Word of warning to people that try to record this or live stream this, be sure you shut off the in-game
symbol
chat.
Art.
Yeah, symbol arts.
Mostly symbol art. You can leave chat by itself.
Yeah,
usually people aren't graphic with just text.
You might run the risk of getting images on that chat box that'll demonetize or get you banned on Twitch.
I showed off the gunblade, now I'm showing off my favorite weapon, the wired lance.
Ooh, I finally get to see this emotion. You talk about this all the time.
Oh, yeah. Wired lance is pretty fun.
Yes, it's my favorite weapon in the game. So beautiful.
Wow, so long range.
It's actually a lot longer range than I expected on a lance. Oh. It didn't even look like you're stabbing people. It looks like you're throwing the lance at them and going and running over and picking it back up.
Just imagine that one dude from Bleach with, like, that one weapon, Zabimaru.
I told him to look at Omega Red, and that's the Wired Lance.
Yeah.
Well, Ikaku is the one that has the actual lance as a sword.
Dick. Good thing these guys can't damage me worth a damn.
Yeah, those big bugs just drop a bunch of like little pods and stuff that'll spawn into enemies eventually.
They spawn some more fall spawn, yeah.
So either take the big guy out, or if like the one you see them starting to drop down, I think you could take them out mid-air to keep them from even starting to spawn in the first place.
They can
place.
Be stun locked very easily.
Oh boy. So what's the maximum party size you can have on a single player run?
You're doing this on your own. You're not having a party.
Oh, because it looks like you have two other people that you can play with.
Those are exclusive to the story, for this ongoing story. You're not gonna have that all the time.
Okay, yeah. Fair enough.
Yeah, whoever your party is, it's because they're relevant to the current story.
Okay.
I just like how you grabbed him midair. You fucking flung him into the wall. Just
get the fuck out of here. What the fuck is that shit?
Logic, have you beaten the last episode of this quite yet, or no?
I think I'm still on episode one, honestly.
Oh.
From my understanding and from what Luigi's told me, episode one takes for goddamn ever.
Listen, if Tales of Crystorius episode one, chapter one takes for fucking ever,
no, it's even longer than that.
No, I know. I'm saying, I can easily believe this would have long episodes.
This is a Dark Regane. He's the mid boss you're gonna see a lot.
If I remember correctly, these enemies also usually have like weak spots and stuff that you can tell,
yes.
Right?
Yes. For this one in particular, you want to actually take out its legs.
Yeah.
Because then it'll be stunned. Yep. Like so. You can tell you hit a weak spot when you actually do more damage on that end.
Oh, so this is where Capcom got the idea to do Monster Hunter. That makes sense.
Oh, hell no. Monster Hunter is the law.
This predates a lot. The Monster Hunter predates this game.
Monster Hunter is
relaxed.
Like fucking what?
Really
mid to
joke.
Late 90s?
Technically, it doesn't if you count the original Phantasy Stars.
Anyways, he does those wave beams. He jumps around a lot. It's just a giant spider.
Spooter.
Spider. That's when you know it's weakened.
Mm-hmm.
My weapon sucks dick.
Well, it's a level one blade. What do you expect? Do you have any special moves, or do you have to unlock those later?
You have to learn those.
Yeah, it's like
you get special discs that you find on around the map, and that'll give you your special moves.
Okay.
Yeah, it's like most skills are kind of exclusive to certain classes and whatnot. But at the same time, you could learn just about any skill, like regardless of whatever class you're playing right now, and you'll have access for it for that class later if you switch to it.
Correct. All right.
I do kind of see the similarities you were saying, Logic, to like Xenoblade with like just the artistic style.
Something like that.
Oh boy, photon blast time!
That's where the giant fuck you laser.
Nope, giant.
You didn't tell me this was gonna have Pokemon battles.
Stab the shit out of it.
Stomp that fucker.
Straight up Pokemon battle.
Stomp the shit out of it.
I have to go now. My planet needs me.
That's what mags do. When you get a mag of your own, feed it only one type of weapon.
All thanks to you two standing front. Yeah. Appreciate the help.
Also, Xeno, your mag is hungry. You might want to do something about that.
Your mag gets hungry every 30 seconds.
No, it doesn't. Not every 30 seconds. Like almost every like 5 minutes or so.
Yeah, it drains their energy quick.
Again, I'm just remembering back when Luigi and my friend Exor were doing their live streams, and like I would notice like every 5 minutes, like your mag's hungry. Like, yeah, I know, I'm not gonna feed it right now. I'm in the middle of a battle.
Rare items.
Well, it's more important if you feed it because it gives you buffs when it's not hungry.
Yep. Increase your mag to level 200.
Oh boy. That sure won't take forever.
I bet it won't.
Oh boy, that's why you have to get. That's why you gotta use DLC and pay for it yourself. I'm glad
you made it back. You wish that was the case.
That's what Sega wants. Yes, that's what Sega wants you to think. You think I
bought something? just flip the name card. It tells Konami.
Sega.
It's like that one.
I thought you. Konami, I thought you guys went out of business. Yes, that's what we wanted you to think.
It's like that one episode of The Simpsons.
Must crush capitalism.
God damn it.
Don't sweat the details, kid. Let the higher-ups worry about it, or get stuck figuring it out for yourself.
Anyway, yeah, the lip flaps are horrible.
This is Xeno and Echo. They're totally not in a relationship, I swear to God. That's about all
I can tell you. I believe it,
guys.
The hard truth about life and arcs right away. It's mostly one-sided, I'll tell you that right now. Illusions, at least.
Gee, I wonder why. Kids just got thrust into the middle of a battlefield.
They must be shocked. Well, no, yes, I have PTSD. I must retire now. And
how do you think I got this scar?
You act like Xeno gives a shit about retiring. Come on, that's cute. Made it back in one piece,
right? I'm totally not a badass. That's cause to
celebrate. He's not. He really is.
I know. That's the joke.
He's a fucking dork is what he is. Nothing
makes sense. I'm totally not going to turn evil or something. I don't know. I have no idea. I have no opinion.
Stop trying to predict the plot, because everything you're going to say is wrong.
Everything you know is wrong. Zeno's got away with
words, doesn't he? So he's not an idiot? So I'm wrong about that?
Thanks, Echo. He's not an idiot. He anyway, just copies stuff.
Yeah, fair enough. Is my
wisdom. He does like to talk about his mentor a lot. And besides, you always do whatever you want, never giving a thought to all my hard work. You have papers. Yeah. Is it my fault you're always
late? I do like his Tron outfit, though.
That's why I kept calling him Zero. I gotta do all the paperwork, yeah.
Oh, that was quick. That means episode one ought to go real smoothly.
Shifty eyes.
Hey, episodes are only 27 minutes long. This won't take forever.
Until you realize they're all fragmented.
Oh, rank Z. Easy. I mean S. Seriously, it looks like a Z every time I see it.
Don't get really used to getting an S rank, especially on the urgent quests.
Yeah.
You get S ranks more often than not.
No, you won't.
You do.
No, your... I don't.
That's usually because you're playing with other people that help you get it.
Just wait till you play the mining base. You'll never get an S rank.
I've watched you and my friend Xor play it.
You'll never get an S rank on the mining base defense missions ever.
Not like it matters anyway.
At the last minute, you always have one base get destroyed, and you're starting to curse out everything.
Yeah,
sounds about right.
Here's our main hub.
Which?
Oh, did you record this during like any raids or anything? Or are those
I did record. I did sort of record this during the Independence Day event.
Oh boy, is that going to carry over to one of the episodes?
Just this one.
Aww. That was so good, though.
Yeah. For those who don't know, Independence Day event, they apparently it was designed by people who have no idea how to celebrate Independence Day.
So Japan.
So they just threw the Statue of Liberty in the shopping center, decorated all the trees with Christmas decorations that looked like they were spray painted red, white, and blue. And they just randomly have fireworks in the background. Also, they had like the Liberty Bell in the main gateway for some reason. I don't know why.
Hey, cut them some slack. At least Japan got did some research on it. At least they got the fireworks right.
No, yeah, they definitely got the fireworks part right, because in the entire month leading up to the 4th of July here, there was always fucking fireworks of the illegal variety being shut on, being fucking shot out into the air fucking God knows how long.
Sounds about right.
You're not going to get.
But I don't think. I don't think it was accurate enough because there wasn't enough collateral damage.
Shit, you're right. They forgot to include the part where a stray firework set fire to my neighbor's backyard.
There's the music.
Wait, that actually happened?
No, yeah, that actually happened a few months back. Well, not a few months back. A few weeks back.
Yikes. Hey, look, Erza. Holy shit, man!
Erza, come back.
We'll
never see her again.
By the way, this is the music that was playing during that event. It sounds incredibly patriotic. Oh, that reminds me. I need to talk about the costume they used for Uncle Sam. They basically turned him into a.
I remember this.
They turned him into a goddamn superhero. It's amazing.
Like they did literally Major Glory.
Yes, they had his suit look like Major Glory. He had the American flag as a cape.
Like, if there's one thing, like,
he had one of the stars from the Star Spangled Banner on his chest.
So it was like they were trying to do Captain America, but a really shitty version of Captain America.
Yeah. I'll show you what it looks like in post, but it's hilarious. I swear to God.
Which is ironic, considering I'm pretty sure Japan knows what Captain America looks like.
Oh, I do. I'm pretty sure that was completely intentional. You are about to embark on a grand
adventure on the universal stage. Lionel, what are you doing? As
a member of, he wants to see this whole freaking cutscene. In
PSO2, he wants you to pet him, of course. Participate in
ARC's missions. Who is she on? I wonder. Oh well, we'll figure that out later.
Someday.
Foreshadowing for the main menu, for blah blah parts down the line.
Hell yeah, simple missions.
Yay, daily missions.
Are you gonna show off daily missions, or are you just gonna
Purple Man? However,
ARC's missions. I mean, the daily missions are really just there for like XP and whatnot.
Yeah.
And
Purple Man.
Oh God!
I think I fought this guy before.
I didn't think you were doing Five Nights at Freddy's. Holy shit!
What?
The Purple Man.
Oh, wrong, geez. Purple Man. Also, wait, this place isn't accurate at all. There should be more dancing people.
Right. Plus, it's not accurate to how it was when it first released on PC. There's not anywhere near enough lag.
Or crashing in general.
It never crashed on me. It just chugged at a freaking 2 frames per second.
I remember trying to watch your stream, and then I had to immediately jump over to Luigi's because I couldn't follow anything that was going on.
Yeah, it was bad when it launched on PC for the for North American users. It was god-awful.
Then I hopped over to my friend Xor's, and it was just as chuggy, and I'm like, oh god, I'm just kind of glad I haven't bought this game yet.
It doesn't help
logic,
that ship
logic,
like shit.
I think it was hilarious that you're bringing up lag because it was like, man, there was too much lag.
God damn it.
God damn it.
Okay, we'll see you in part 2 when I regain my composure.
Yay.